Next, we have a video about different types of animal cruelty and signs of abuse.
Animal neglect is the failure to provide basic care required for an animal to thrive. Animal neglect can occur in many ways, such as hoarding. A person who keeps far more animals than they can care for is guilty of animal hoarding. Lack of veterinary care. Untreated wounds, emaciation, scabs, and hair loss can be signs of an untreated disease. Inadequate shelter. Extreme heat or cold can be potentially deadly for animals and pets. Dogs that are continuously chained up can suffer tremendously from social isolation and exposure. Abandonment. Lots of cats and dogs die every year from being abandoned or left for dead. Direct violence to an animal is cruel, upsetting, and illegal. Anytime you see an animal being hurt in any way, call authorities immediately.
Christmas is here, and our high school does many things to help celebrate.
One of these is a program called High Tech Christmas. Next on the High, we look at the people who put this program on and a few students who are part of it.
High Tech Christmas is just a really great program that we kind of contain right here at the high school, and it is our own students helping out other students who maybe need a little help, you know, at this time of year. When I started being the advisor for NHS, we became involved in that, and it's really one of the favorite things that we do throughout the year, because it's so important for them to be able to help students, you know, that are in classes with them.
High Tech Christmas is a program that the high school and the tech center participate in that allows students who may not have the means to have a Christmas still receive presents and get to celebrate Christmas. Student Council has for at least the last 15 years, we've always adopted students who are needy. And just in the last it's probably been in the last 4 or 5 years, we opened that up to additional organizations. National Honor Society also participates now, and the Tech Center. Previously, we were only able to probably sponsor about 4 kids, and now we're up to about 75 with both of those organizations being able to help.
It is a program that we have money donated to us by a local company here in town, Independent Stave, and they donate the money to us and just so we can make sure that our students here at Lebanon School District have a good Christmas. This is my second year here at LTCC, so I've done this for 2 years, but they have done it for a total of 4 years. We really appreciate the support of Independent Stave and the money that they provide for us so that we can make sure that our students have a great Christmas.
High Tech Christmas is something we started here at the tech school a few years ago, where I have a local company that has donated a sum of money. And what we do is we try to distinguish students that are in need of things for Christmas. Maybe they don't live at home, or maybe they're from a broken home, or maybe they just financially burdened this time of year. And we interview them, we select the ones that seem to need the help, and then the teachers all gather up with students and different clubs and organizations, and we purchase Christmas for these kids. And sometimes it's a heartbreaking thing, because they ask for stuff for somebody other than themselves. And it's what the season's for. Since it started, when it started, I couldn't give an exact date. I've been at the school 16 years, and we've always done something for Christmas for kids. It's a great program, and it breaks my heart. It just makes me thankful for the season.
one of my key roles is getting everything organized, shopping dates, helping getting the names organized, how many kids we can take, how many kids we can afford to buy for, and then shopping, of course. That's probably my biggest role, and it's the most fun, in my opinion. We get things that they want. We try to get a few things on their want list, like their favorite snacks, makeup, a little stereo CD player, MP3 player, something like that as well, too.
I'm Shelby Meiser, and this year down in the LTCC, we have boxes in every room to collect change, loose change, any type of change to raise money to buy 600 pounds of potatoes for families in need for Share Christmas.
Noah. Hi, I'm Creighton Blattle. I'm a senior this year, and this year for the Lebanon Barnwarming, the candidates decorated their own jars, and we had the fellow students put change in them, such as quarters, dimes, nickels, pennies, half dollars, gold dollars, just whatever change they could round up. And we raised $750, as that's just for 8 people, so that's pretty darn good for only 8 people. And my partner, which I had the privilege of having as my partner, was Madison Pendergraft, AKA Peppermint Patty. And she was just a great partner, couldn't ask for a better partner. And this year we're gonna use that money and we're gonna adopt children for Christmas. We're gonna buy what they want or what they need.
Foreign exchange students.
Here at Lebanon High School, we have students who have come from different parts of the world.
Next on the Hive, you'll get to know the foreign exchange students a little better.
Here is Bagrationi. It's one of our countrysides, Abkhazeti, our side of the country. It's like, it's not longer ours because Russia took us from us, but it was really popular resort for tourists. It's Samegrelo-Zemosvaneti. It's one of the mountain regions in Georgia, and it's really famous for its food and national costume. Here you see, and by the way, each region has like their own style of national costume. So, this is Adjaria. Adjaria is located by southwest of Georgia, by the Black Sea. So it's really popular resort for tourists and all the Georgians. Here is their Adjarian Khachapuri, one of the national dish, and it's their version. This is Guria. Guria is famous for their hospitality, but also their beauty nature. And they have like their own technique to build houses. And their traditional food, Godinakli, which is like cooked for our New Year. So this is Kakheti. This is a like side of wine. It's located in eastern of Georgia. So it's chuchela, our traditional, here you see. It's cooked together with gozina and it takes like 3 days. It's one of the mountain regions of Georgia, another one. It's really cold there, so not many people live there, but they are really tough. And they don't really go to the city when they live there. This is my capital, which was like created in 4th and 3rd century BC, Tbilisi. Here you see Kartlis Deda, our statue, which means you receive one friend with a friendly gesture, one cup of wine in one hand, and another sword, which means for enemies. This was like what my city looked like when it was old, and this is one of the older districts of the city, and it was really different than it is now. So Georgia is also the country of wine. They have like hundreds of different techniques of making wine, and it's really delicious. It's like goes from the hardest to softest, for even children can drink them. So Georgia has like 3 alphabets, Nuskhuri, Asumtavruli, and Mkhedruli, but only one Mkhedruli is used in our modern language. So, and it's one of the 14 countries that have their unique alphabet, different from anyone. This is a Webris Ausani, a knight in the panther skin, which was like written by our world famous author Shota Rustaveli in 13th century in honor of our queen Tamar, which ruled in golden age. These are famous Georgians, Ilya Chavchavadze, which established Georgia the way it is now, helped it win struggles. This is the other one is Jakub Kogibashvili, which developed the alphabet for for little children, and they are like they helped them. There's our national costumes. As I already said, each region has a really different costume, and it represents the nature of each region. But this one unites all the nations. So, and Georgia, most in Georgian population are like 87% of Georgians, and the others are Jews and Armenians and Russians. We are really friendly nation, so we have a lot of different backgrounds. So you can ask any questions you want.
You know what I'm hungry for? I'm hungry for some Italian food. And you know what? We have Christmas break coming up really soon. So you guys are gonna get out of school early on December 19th. You ought to take your family and head up to Prime Italian Bistro at their St. Robert location. You do that and kick off the holiday celebrations with a fine Italian meal. And the proceeds from that night are gonna benefit Globally Strong Culture Fair in March. So it is a really great way to start your holiday, and you're doing a good thing for your fellow students.
Creighton, what are your family traditions?
We open presents.
Well, next on the Hive, we asked the student and faculty here at LHS how they got into the holiday spirit and what interesting traditions their families do together.
It was the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there.
My family gets into the holiday spirit by putting up our Christmas tree and listening to Christmas carols.
Well, my dad puts up blow-up dolls all through the house and outside the house. 273 Jefferson Street, come check it out.
By the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. Mama and her kerchief and I and my cap had jumped.
To get in the holiday spirit, I dyed my hair red and I loved my Christmas socks.
Kerchief and I and my cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash.
To get in the Christmas spirit, my family and I, we decorate the house together, we put up the tree, we bake Christmas cookies, and we do a lot of family-oriented activities. We are just all about family when it comes to any of the holidays, and
Tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name, on Dasher, on Dancer, on Prancer.
To get in the holiday spirit, I am nice to people.
And I like to drink eggnog.
And I like to roast chestnuts on open fire.
Oh, now dash away, dash away, dash away all, as the dry leaves.
I think that decorating before Thanksgiving is too early.
They meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers, they flew.
I think that decorating before Thanksgiving is too early to decorate, just because I feel like it's a forgotten holiday.
I heard on the roof the pawing and prancing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning...
Merry Christmas!
For more than 10 years, the Jones family has shared the true meaning of Christmas in an old-time Christmas village.
Next, we look at the Jones family Christmas in the holler.
I'm Brenda Jones, and I own the Jones Christmas in the Holler.
Jones Christmas in the Holler is a display of thousands of lights and a walk-through village that is reminiscent of Christmas past. The family hopes that it will change the hearts of who attend. Also, that it shows the true meaning of Christmas.
Through the years, we've added the walkthrough village that you can go in every little building. And we have a general store, a post office, a school, a little church, a cabin. And this year, we're going to have the little lit village that you can just walk through and look at also.
The history of Jones Christmas in the Holler spans back for 15 years.
One of the things is, if you have a lot of ice, it's really, really hard on your Christmas lights and your blow-ups. You just can't even hardly use them. Also, the wind is really, really hard. The worst thing that happened probably was one year we plugged in a new blow-up, and it was brand new, and it completely blew out like half of the lights. We had to replace all of them. So that was a pretty serious thing. Some good things is we really enjoy visiting with people and making little kids happy. And we've had Oliver's Ozarks out here to interview us, and we was on Channel 10 a few years back.
Behind the scenes, I got to watch and listen to Ray and his family work hard to achieve their goal of running Jones Christmas in the Holler. Said the night wind to the little lamb. Do you see? Some of the reactions to Jones Christmas in the Holler were surprising. Local resident Jessie Hill and her family, including her husband Brandon, said that they were so impressed they would come back every year.
Really pretty. It's fun.
I like having fun and just getting together.
I just like having fun, helping, decorating.
This is Dustin Price reporting for The Hive.
To the shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear?
And our runner-up, Creighton Blattle. If for any reason our queen cannot fulfill her duties, next on The Hive, we celebrate this year's pageantry of Miss Merry Christmas.
This year, I competed in the Lebanon Area Chamber of Commerce Miss Merry Christmas pageant. I got to meet a lot of new girls and experience the pageant life.
Miss Merry Christmas is contestant number 11, Renee Hudson.
Tis the season to be jolly. Fa ra 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 ra, ra ra ra.
Here are some highlights from our annual Christmas concert at LHS Choir Performs.
As you're enjoying family time, wish our veterans a Merry Christmas and thank them for their hard work and service.
Merry Christmas!
Thank you for your services. Happy holidays and God bless.
Next on the Hive, we will be looking at Lebanon's annual Christmas tree lighting ceremony, which was held Tuesday evening on December 2nd.
It was a wonderful night for everyone to gather around and enjoy the Christmas spirit.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know.